My name is Carlos Chalisea. I'm the owner and founder of Don Luchos restaurant and Pisco Bar, and this is a day in my life. One of the first stops is gonna be the store usually. This is Carlo from Don Luchos. I would like to put in an order, please. We got all kinds of mayhem in the kitchen today. The business plan changed altogether. There's a lot more money involved in that. But for the food truck, we like doing the option of sandwiches or rice bowls. Perfect, we got an event for the food truck. Let's see, where's the chicken at? Truck's not turning on. Come on. You gotta constantly be tasting. That's why I'm getting fat. Can I get a soup, Joey?
Yeah.
Yeah? So guess who has to go save the day now again? Oh, another day. It's about 7:30 a.m. Come on, Chico. Time to get up, buddy. Time to start the day. And today we have a pretty packed agenda. We got a lot of stuff going on, a little remodeling at the spot. We got chef coming through, food truck going out, and some stuff we need to buy, which is part of the every morning routine pretty much. Luchito. Oh, almost. All right, off we go. It's my sidekick for today. Being an entrepreneur, I don't believe there's necessarily a pattern. Definitely a lot of knowledge that you can soak up from other people that are already doing it. Yeah, having a pattern and paying attention to what others have done and the lane that you are going and trying to grow is something that will definitely help you in the long run and in the short run too. It's just a formula for growth, I would say. One of the first stops is gonna be the store usually. Potato. Limes. And this is my least favorite part of the place. It's super cold in there. These are nice and healthy. Look at that. I'm gonna take spring mix. Got the sliced carrots here. But yeah, I think we're all set.
And I like 476.37.
All right. All right, I got my pyramid here.
Oh yeah?
Trying to make sure I don't drop anything.
Okay.
See, a lot of this stuff I just usually do on my own. Don't really want to pay somebody to come along with me. Defeats the purpose of me doing all the buying. But then it would just almost be more worth it to get it delivered if I'm gonna have to pay somebody to do this. See, this is where you get your workout. I like doing it too because it's a workout. Don't really get to go to the gym much anymore, but we can say this counts. Yeah, I've been wanting to get one of those watches just to see how many calories I'm actually going through by doing this stuff on a daily basis. Almost every day, there's something to buy. We're set to go. All right. Whew, I'm sweating. We're headed to the restaurant, gonna unload everything. Now here we got a dump run because we're doing construction today. So we got a bunch of things we gotta take to the dump. I'm running a little behind. We're gonna have to speed it up.
Katrina Bakery, Rhonda speaking.
Hi Rhonda. This is Carla from Don Luchos. I would like to put in an order, please.
How are you doing today?
So this will be for tomorrow, 5 ounce ciabatta roll. And if I could do 80, please.
For tomorrow?
Yeah, Friday.
Okay.
And then for Saturday, if I could do 80 as well.
Okay, anything else?
That'll do it. Thank you.
That's it. All right, Kelly, you're all set. Thank you.
Thank you, bye-bye. Like that. All right, we got two teams here right now, kitchen team and fix it all team, handyman. See what I'm talking about, folks? This is good cardio. And with the rain, it makes you want to just go a little bit quicker. All right, unload was successful. So I was thinking about some of the things that we wanted to mention, and one of the things that really has helped grow throughout this period of, you know, through the pandemic and all that, has been implementing online ordering, making it easy for people to order with just a touch of a button. Like, we've been doing ads through Instagram, Facebook, for you to actually just, you know, you're sitting there going about your daily scanning through stuff, and just boom, here pops up Don Luchos, where you can, you know, you'll see a plate, and then it's next thing it is, it's taking you to our website so you can order. Right now I have a guest chef that has showed up, and I have a full crew right now in the kitchen. So we're gonna go visit them and see what they're doing. And you know, what I like about the people I have working with me is that people that I can rely on. Not everybody's like that. Of course, I've had some bad apples in the bunch, but thankfully right now, people I'm working with is great. Our guest chef is awesome. He comes every Thursday, does a special, always on time, always has something new. Transparency with your employees and a plan of where you see them going really keeps people motivated, you know. For him, what I'm doing there is I'm helping somebody, a friend of mine, great Peruvian chef, but I'm helping him towards him opening up his own business, his own restaurant. All right, so here we are. So yeah, Luchito's part of the cleaning team. Inspects every table, make sure that there's no leftovers. Daniel here, which is a nice coincidence, he shows up. He helps me do all the technology side of, Axel, ¿cómo estás?
Bien, ¿y tú?
Bien, bien. He helps me do all the technology side. I was just talking about the online ordering, like he helped me implement everything. And Luchito's super excited about the fact that he helped implement all that. We're gonna leave Luchito here for a little while with a bone while I take care of some business. I don't leave him here, folks, just in case it's not a case of abandoning the pet outside. Well, I'll be back with him shortly. We got all kinds of mayhem in the kitchen today. It's an action-packed day. We got a talk to our guest chef over here. Joey needs some chicken. He's gonna do some a special chicken soup today. But yeah, so he has his own setup over here. Where we try to, you know, Joey's been the first one to jump on the whole pop-up thing. We do have other exciting people that are doing pop-ups throughout the city that are gonna be showcased here on our truck. And just to remind everybody, this is how we started. We started on a food truck. And now our food truck is, well, food cart. Then this trailer here. And now the trailer is dedicated to the patio. The idea was to do, you know, like private events, weddings, you name it, that type of stuff. But unfortunately, none of that we can do these days. So, but what we can do is we can feature different chefs and, you know, keep the ball rolling like that and bring something cool to the restaurant. Joey,
yeah.
So all the chicken's gonna be in the back. Yeah, and then one of the toughest parts of having a business is the hiring and having people you can trust, people with skills, people that are gonna show up for the job. And honestly, it's I've come to find out that the best way is either through referral, usually through referral, like the people that I've gotten that somebody has recommended, not always, but I would say a high percentage rate end up working out. You know, and then once you do find that person, the majority of people are gonna be very temporary. So it's gonna be very temporary, so it's there's gonna be always like a pretty high turnover rate. So then it's up to you to see which one of those do you want to keep and how are you going to keep them, you know. So I have two people right now that I can say they're my, the constants, you know. So you always got to put things out there that's gonna entice them to wanna keep on working with you, you know? Everybody's got their dreams. I mean, shoot, I don't wanna see somebody or my dishwasher working for me for, you know, 2, 4, 5 years. I mean, obviously, the idea for anybody is to be able to, you know, keep on growing in a company or wherever you're working. I think average span is like about, right around six months, I would say. My chef, right-hand guy, he's been around for about almost like 3 years now, a little over 3 years. But obviously, he's got a lot more stake in what's going on right here, which makes him want to stay around. But it's important to have at least one or two people like that that are invested in the company, and everybody else is going to be, you know, in and out. The girl that does the social media content for me, I do a lot of it myself. It's definitely like the cheaper way to go about it is like you do everything yourself, right? But so much stuff going on, it's kind of hard. So I have somebody that comes and visits us about 2 to 3 times a week on key days. Like today, later today, she'll be here. Right now, I'm waiting for her to send me an email with the content. And what I do is I get the content, the pictures, the videos that she's elaborated, depending on like the event that we're gonna do and all that. And then what I do is I do the post. I like doing the post myself because I know how to word it the way I want and whatnot. But having somebody that does the pictures, the content, the videos is very helpful. So I definitely recommend getting a situation like that going. And you know, social media, everybody's on their phone. So it's definitely the way to go to try to market to everybody uses social media these days. You know, I would say Instagram from 45 year old down, paying a lot of attention to that. So it's definitely something that if you don't have it in your business yet, I know a lot of people are just like, oh, well, you know, I hate doing it for my personal, I don't have one. Well, that's fine. Like you don't have to have one for yourself, but definitely get one for the business. So from the initial plan of like what we were doing over here was, what I was doing with the food trucks, I wanted to have a small hole in the wall was my idea. So, you know, in essence, I was looking for a place that would be pretty similar to what a food truck is, right? So this is what I envisioned as my hole in the wall one day. You know, a place like this, you know, brick and mortar, something small. And then the opportunity came that a person reached out to me that I was going to the food truck there with them and at their shop. And they were like, look, I got this place that might be a good fit for you. Came to check it out. None of this existed. But when I checked it out, it was this over here. So I come in here and I'm like, well, this isn't a hole in the wall. This is a full on restaurant, right? But my whole plan was just doing food. When I come in here, didn't look nothing like this, by the way. Complete makeover in what makeup is. But, you know, I realized it's like, oh, I gotta have a bar. I never really thought about having a bar that soon, but the business plan changed altogether from having a hole in the wall to taking all over this place and being like, you know what? Now I'm gonna go for a full-on restaurant. And it was just a matter of recalibrating and reaching out to some friends that are already in the industry, you know, get some ideas on like, okay, well, how am I gonna, you know, operate a restaurant now? How am I gonna apply for my liquor license? So that was a whole change of a game plan, and I'm glad I did it because it was definitely worth the risk. For me, it was a huge risk. I wasn't too sure if that's what I wanted to do, but hey, in the end, once you get liquor involved, there's a lot more money involved in that. Gracias. All right, folks, it's lunchtime. So I'm gonna sit down and eat really quick. I mean, you guys saw what my breakfast was. Wasn't that much of a breakfast, but I'm starving now at this point. So I'm gonna take a second here to nourish my appetite. We have a fish sandwich today, it's special on the menu. And the next thing I'm gonna be eating is be coming straight out of that food truck right there with our guest chef, which is always nice to have something completely different. Enjoy. I spend most of my day here because there's always stuff that's going on that needs my attention. So let's jump on this call before this lady actually. In order to promote your business, a good way to do it is to get involved in community events. This event in particular is for a church and they're helping the needy. So the church is buying a bunch of meals for people in need. So sounds like something cool that we would love to be a part of. And basically the church gives us, pays us per ticket, right? And it's a reduced cost. So we're also doing a little bit of charity there. You know, that type of stuff is always cool to be a part of.
Hi, Carlo. This is Stephanie.
Hi, Stephanie. How are you? How many meals do trucks usually prep for, so I know how to accommodate my crew and how to put together our prep for the day?
Yeah, so we usually get between 140 and 160 vouchers returned.
That's a busy shift. I consider that, yeah, awesome. Okay, so I'll make sure to have a staff of like about 3 or 4 guys even. But for the food truck, we like doing the option of sandwiches or rice bowls. Would that work?
Okay, that would be fine. We've changed our time because it's, you know, because of the time change, it's so dark.
Yeah.
We aren't really seeing anybody past 6:30, so we're running the food trucks now from 4 to 6:30.
4 to 6:30, yeah, it's perfect. I think I'll just send you this email here and create a thread, and then anything else you need to share with us, I'll be paying attention to that.
Okay, great. Okay. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Stephanie. Thanks for reaching out. All right. Look forward to the event. Thank you. Bye-bye.
Thanks. Bye-bye.
Perfect. We got an event for the food truck. All right, so we're right around 3:30, so this is around the time that the food truck crew is showing up today for the food truck going out. And in the meantime, what was going through my mind is, you know, where do I spend the majority of my day, or how do I spend it in terms of growth for the business and all that? And honestly, it's just kind of all over the place. You know, I think marketing is a really big one. But if you market, you market, you market, and you start growing, and you don't have, you know, the team, and you don't have the product, and you get, say, super busy, and you market it so tough that, you know, you got all these people coming in, and you just don't have the product, then all of a sudden, you didn't do the job. So I think it's important to when you're growing, to grow and make sure you invest your time in every little area. You can't just focus on one, because then all of a sudden, let's say you do marketing, you just focus on marketing all the way. And then all of a sudden, boom, you got all these people coming in, but you didn't train your staff. You don't have a leader inside that's going to help you when you're going and doing the buy and all that. Everything falls apart. So I think in growth, it's very important to dedicate your time to each area. You know, each area needs a little bit of dedication, or else things start getting unbalanced. Let's go check out this little construction project we had today. This is an important area because we have the rotisserie chicken. So we're dealing with fire, we're dealing with you know, stuff that is flammable. See, now we got a nice little rack over here where we can put our wood. You know, here is where the magic happens with the chicken. Let's see, where's the chicken at? 3:30, there should be something in here. Chicken should be in now, 3:32. Chicken man fell asleep. Los pollos, que va a meter los pollos? So we got a man on the job, let's see where he's at. I'm not the type to micromanage, but I think it's very important that people get dialed in. You know, when they're new, they tend to forget. So you gotta be on top of it, making sure stuff gets done at the right time. Chicken should be in at 3:30. There he was, he's right in the process of taking it out, so that's perfect timing. See, and this fits about 80 chickens. Now, this is something a little too big for what we want. I'm gonna probably downgrade and get one that's 30. This came with the place, so I figured I'd keep it. But let me tell you, I don't think we're ever gonna do the amount of chicken. This was for a barbecue place. They were doing a lot of brisket, all kinds of stuff over here. And that's fine, you know, if you have a big one like that, when you're focused on just brisket and stuff like that, or stuff coming out of the smoker. But we have a bunch of dishes, so I don't think we'll be getting to that level of 80 chickens in this thing, you know? Look at those birds. Now let me show you over here where all the flames coming out. It's a beauty, huh? Yeah, so now we're nice and neat over here. You can actually find stuff. Before there was stuff just all over the floor, it was a mess. Our customers know that chicken comes out at 5 p.m. If we don't have chicken at 5 p.m., we look bad. You know, this is something, a trend that we've set now for some time, that people expect chicken to be coming out of the restaurant at 5. Now, if he forgets, you know, and doesn't do it for a half an hour, then that sets us back a half hour. We look bad. We already have pre-orders of people coming to pick up their food at 5. So that's going back to what I was already talking about, being consistent, making sure that we always, you know, hit certain marks. If we say we're going to be there, or if we say we're going to have something at a certain time, we need to have it. And we have Joey, needs to start putting out, in about half an hour, he needs to start putting out plates. He has some pre-orders as well. Yeah, you know, like sometimes, you know, in business is not perfect. Always expect the unexpected. It's about how you rebound. You know, sometimes you'll make a terrible move and then you just have to figure out how you're gonna bounce back and figure out how to, you know, gather your composure and come up with a new strategy, you know? Just like a game of chess, you know, you lose your queen, game's not over. You still have a bunch of options that you can do. It's about regrouping and reconsidering. I think one of the mistakes that I made was at the beginning, I held on to my for sure job for a little bit longer than I should have, I believe, just for a sense of security. And you know, if I were to do it all over again, I maybe would have cut it a little bit shorter. So here's a food truck thing going on here. Hey, what's up, Mark?
Hey, look, I've been playing with the truck with the shifter and stuff, but it's no power when I go to crank over the ignition.
Are you sure? Do you have it on park the way it should?
Yeah, I'm taking it in and out several times, and it doesn't
Nothing.
Seem to be doing anything. So.
Okay, let me call the mechanic still around. Let me give him a shout. I'm going to walk over there right now. So expect the unexpected, like I said. Food truck's supposed to be somewhere in about 10 minutes. We're running late. Truck's not turning on. So now my attention gets shifted from the restaurant over here to the truck and see what's going on. Guy doing all the work in the chicken room there, he's also my mechanic. So very important to have a handyman, people. Have somebody who knows how to do everything. So.
You give it a try. I've tried like every trick thing.
Huh.
Yeah.
I'm gonna just bring my truck really quick.
Okay.
The main challenge is for you to get out of your kitchen and get to the place you're going on time and be able to serve on time, right? Restaurants, it's a little bit easier because you don't have to move. You're there, you just gotta assemble everything inside. So bottom line is, a lot of people say, oh, the food truck's easier. Food truck's a little more difficult than the restaurant in some aspects. An aspect, you have to get organized, you gotta remember to bring everything. Because once you're out, you forgot the chicken, you're screwed. No chicken that day. You gotta have the right people you can call. You know, in this case, I have an electrician on call. I have a mechanic on call. I have a lot of people that can help me solve whatever goes wrong. A ver, será? And I just got new batteries. Come on, truck. Come on. All right, you saved the day. So we have the truck going out right now, and we're going to a pretty cool brewery in the area. We got our daily bread. And this is what I talk about the food truck. It's like, you know, the restaurant, everything's there. You just gotta put stuff in place. But here, we gotta make sure we remember to bring all our utensils. There's been times the truck goes out, they forget the cooler, and we have no utensils. All right, off we go. All right, truck's running good. Next thing we gotta do is we gotta taste this stuff that Joey brought in today. Don't think that the stuff is always gonna be coming out the way you want it. Always taste it. You gotta constantly be tasting. That's why I'm getting fat. Joey. Can I get a soup, Joey? Yeah? Here we have our guest chef today presenting. Look at this heartwarming soup. Spicy sauce. We have the Andean corn right there. Green onions. Make sure to throw a little bit of everything in there. Just got a message here. Let's see what's going on. There's a food truck crew right now. So what'd I tell you? Turns out they forgot a pot and they forgot the special that we're supposed to do, the brisket. So guess who has to go save the day now again? Follow me. They're already open for business, so That means they can't sell any of the special that we had lined up today on the menu until I get there. So we're gonna try to hurry up and hopefully, you know, it looks super bad when you have a special on the board and then somebody comes to order it and you're like, well, actually, I can't sell that to you. Luckily, you're not too far away. There's been times I gotta go completely across town to go save the food truck because they forgot the bread or they forgot the utensils. All right, so we made it to the spot. Let's get these people what they forgot. All right, special delivery.
All right.
Special delivery. All right, all set? You guys didn't forget anything else?
No.
All right. Good. All right.
All right, thanks.
The day's been saved. All right, folks, so this is the wrap of the day. I was able to save it. You know, it was a good feeling for the crew that I was actually able to make it over here, and then we're going to call it a night. As you can see, we got a lot of people over here. It's a busy spot, so we want to make sure that whenever we go to a place where people are expecting, you know, the good service that we do, that we show up and we do the job right. So we're gonna call it a night, call it a wrap. Hey, you guys have seen a lot of stuff going on today. So thank you, appreciate it, and good luck in your business. All right, folks,